Hi. Just letting you know that we've had the team's expectations through for the upcoming qualifying session.
Welcome to the only figure of eight track on the F1 calendar. We're here at Suzuka for qualifying today ahead of the Japanese Grand Prix. It always looked like the kind of track that asks an awful lot of the rear tyres, such as the frequency of low-speed exits.
Well, tyre management is key here, specifically the rears. It's all too easy to overheat and wear the rear tyres if they're punished out of the low-speed corners. Most teams won't be able to avoid some kind of issue here, especially the teams that are running less downforce.
As we wind down from the excitement of qualifying, here's a look at your top three. Hamilton, Rosberg and a Renault. It's time to leave for now, but we'll be back tomorrow when the Grand Prix itself gets underway.
Hi, Zema here. Just wanted to let you know what the team are hoping for in the race.
Live today from the Mie Prefecture of Japan as we look forward to the Japanese Grand Prix. The 2015 race here was one of only five Grand Prix in history to feature no retirements at all. Although with the highly competitive field we have today, I don't expect we'll be repeating that stat anytime soon. A lap of this historic racetrack covers 3.6 miles, and it's the only time during the season that we race on a figure of eight racetrack. The drivers can expect some intense G-forces through the 18 corners on offer here as they experience some of the highest average apex speeds on the Formula One calendar. And keep an eye out for overtakes going into the final chicane. Joining me to talk you through the action today is Anthony Davidson. And give us an idea of what kind of thing you're going to be looking out for today.
Well, the big question for me is whether or not we're going to see the cars able to follow each other closely enough to overtake, especially through the fast sections here. Of course, we've got DRS, and that will help on the straights, But it's still no good if you're coming off the previous corner too slowly or too far behind.
We're still in with a chance of winning the title. We need you to push as hard as you can in the five remaining races.
Well then, after an exciting qualifying session yesterday, let's take a look at how the cars line up. An immense lap from Lewis Hamilton yesterday puts him on pole position, and Nico Rosberg completes the front row. Looking down the rest of the grid, we have a Renault, Ricciardo, Valtteri Bottas, and Vettel, Massa, Raikkonen, Verstappen, and Fernando Alonso, Sainz, Perez, Daniel Kvyat, and Button, Grosjean, Magnussen, Esteban Gutierrez, and Nico Hülkenberg, Harry Anto, and Ericsson. Felipe Nasr and Pascal Wehrlein completes the grid. And now it's time to head down to the track. brilliant stuff from Mercedes today. That's another historic win. Tell me, Ant, what was the key to this success?
Well, I think the track conditions just really suited their car today. Wind, track temperature, you name it. These cars come alive when the tyres are just at the right temperature. So the more easily you can keep them there, the better your race tends to go. And that's exactly what happened. Their car just looks so comfortable out there.
So as I say that, we can see the drivers coming out now to collect their trophies. It's yet more silverware to take back to their base in Brackley after another excellent Grand Prix. And after this round of the World Championship, here's how things look in the drivers' table. Well, the gap at the top of the championship has been cut down after a difficult race today for our championship leader. And now I'd like to ask you, Anthony Davidson, who was your driver of the day?
Well, my driver of the day was Nico Hülkenberg. He did a cracking job moving through the field and just highlighting why he's so highly rated in the paddock.
The Constructors' title may already be decided, but with that result, Mercedes secure the Constructors' title. They've been truly outstanding since the very first round of what's been a thrilling championship. Meanwhile, good work from Force India this weekend, who pushed themselves further up the order. After all this drama, you'd be mad not to join us for the next race. We hope to see you then. Take care.